hearts and minds for the sermon that's coming up. We're going to sing the hymn of preparation, Near the Cross, found on page 94 in your hymnals.
Jesus, keep me near the cross.
Pastor John, for giving me this opportunity to speak one again.
Amen.
My scriptures are going to be two chapters, but it's starting in 1 John chapter 4, starting at verse 7. And it reads, "Dear friends, let us not love one another, for love comes from God." I'm sorry, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God has showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. Going down to verse 16, and it reads, "If you see any brother or sister commit sin, does not lead to death. You should pray, and God will give them life." I refer to those whose sin does not lead to death. There's a sin that leads to death. I am not saying that you should pray about that. All wrongdoing is sin. And there is sin that does not lead to death. But we know that everyone born of God does not continue to sin. The one who was born of God keeps them safe, and the new one did not harm them. We know that we are children of God, and that the whole world is under the control of the evil. We know also that the Son of God has come and has given us understanding, so that we may know him who is true. And we are in him who is true by being in his Son, Jesus Christ. He is the true God and eternal life. Children, keep yourself from idols. My topic for this morning is going to be not loving the ways of ungodly people in the world.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. First John is written about love of God. And how there's so much in this world that most of us at times place God, unfortunately, on the back burner. Sin and love of the world seems more pleasurable than putting our whole heart doing the righteous acts. The world is doing a mind control game on us. For instance, the movies, TV shows, music videos, and even commercials place a sin of lust, backbiting, and trickery of mistreatment of others. It's as if it's a fashionable thing to do.
Yeah.
The world has, or should I say, is portraying that there is no light at the end of the tunnel, but only darkness. But in verse 5, in verse John chapter 1 states, God is the light.
Yeah.
And that in him, there is no darkness at all.
Amen.
And if we continue to walk in darkness, we do not have to live, we do not live after truth. But if we, as stated in verse 7 of John, first John, that we will walk in the light, and he, as he is the light in us, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, purifies us all from sin. As of today, we're witnessing the power of false leaders. The spiritual words of hatred, deception, falsehood that misleads and hides the truth. And use the term fake news. There are some that even use God's name in vain to accomplish their mind control status. But we have to be careful about judging others. Matthew chapter 7 reads, "Do not judge, or you too will be judged.
Yeah.
For in the same way, judge others, you will be judged, and with the measure you will use it, it will be measured to you." So let's break away from that old saying of, now don't get me wrong, I'm not judging. And most individuals, when they make that statement, doesn't realize that that's just a sin. Society has made many into lovers of the world instead of lovers of God and his words. Chapter 2 of 1 John 15 says, "Do not love the world or anything in the world, for if anyone loves the world, love for his Father is not in them." There are those that try their very best to turn most people away from the teachings of God. But if you read 1 John chapter 2, verse 18 and 27, about the warnings denying the Son, about the words denying the Son, I love verse 1 of chapter 3, which says, "See what great love the Father has lavished upon us, that we should be children of God, and that is what we are." The reason the world does not want us to know him, but that is the reason the world does not know us, that it needs to know him. Verse 13 of chapter 3 says, "Do not be surprised, my brothers and sisters, if the world hates you." It goes on to state in verse 10 to 15 that we know that we have passed from death to life, because we love each other, and that anyone who does not love remains in death. Verse 13, "Anyone who hates a brother or sister is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has eternal life residing in him." It's amazing. So many that said they're Christians and lovers and followers of God and believe in his words, but hate me because of my race. Mm. have killed others of my race and still say that they're followers of God and his teachings. But it was there go again. I'm judging now. I'm just saying, am I judging or am I curious? So here in verse 3 of John, verse 11, chapter 3 of John, verse 11, it says, it helps my curiosity and it states, dear friends, do not imitate what is evil, but what is good. Anyone who does not, who does what is good is from God. And anyone who does what is evil is not seen, have not seen God. The evildoers need to take heed to the teachings of the Bible about love for one another. It's true to say that one individual wants to harm on the innocence of others. How did that evil and hatred take over and consume their very being? The book of Jude, verse 14, reads Enoch, the seventh of Adam, prophesied about the sin and doom of ungodly people, saying, see, the Lord is coming with thousands upon thousands of his followers. Verse 15 is to judge everyone and convict all of them of all the ungodly acts they have committed in their ungodliness and all of the divine words ungodly sinners have spoken against him. Verse 16 goes on to describe who they are and says, these people are grumblers and fault finders. They follow their own evil desires and they boast about themselves and flatter others for their own advantage. I looked up the meaning of the word flatter. And it can go in different ways. But in this case, let's go with this meaning, which says lavish, insecure praise and compliments upon someone, especially to further one's own interests. In the book of Jude tells us to watch out for these type of people because they follow their own ungodly desires.
Yeah.
Unfortunately for us, we have to deal with these individuals that has the coarse power to do evil deeds and can look at us straight in the face and try to convince us that their decisions are the right way to go. But we know the right way to go is we're following our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
And to persevere and to persevere. Jude verse 21 says, keep yourselves in God's love as you wait for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ to bring you eternal life. It would be so amazing to follow God and his teachings. Now, don't get me wrong, I sympathize with the family of the queen who just passed, but just imagine if we celebrate God's love as much as they are celebrating the passing of the queen. Just think if they could televise God's love and to be in obedience with God and following God's word, be televised 5 days a week. Just what they are doing for the queen. Nothing she can do for you. God can do everything for you.
Amen.
And that's, well, to be honest, he has and he will always do something. But we want to give praises to mankind before we give praises to God. This is amazing. Also, this, I didn't think about it this morning from my wife. I just realized that the day is 9/11. Mm-hmm. And if you think about it, when that occurred, togetherness and everything was good for 2 or 3 days, maybe 4. When everyone was together, everyone was one, all on accord. After that, the racism, the hatred, all began to appear once again. So we got to be careful of the hypocrites, the ones that say that I love you, but I'll stab you in the back. You know, we got to be careful. But it's just nice that we as Christians can show God love, even though they turn their backs on us, talk about us, would rather see us destroyed before they ever see us than to see us accomplish our goal. And our goal, Lord, to live a life that's pertaining to what God wants us to be. I won't be with you long. As a matter of fact, I'm almost finished. But so in closing, I'll leave you with verse 1 and 2. And it reads, to those who have been called, who are loved in God the Father and kept Jesus Christ, mercy, peace, and love be yours in abundance. To all of us that very much. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Minister Jones. Let's give God the praise again. Amen. Not loving the ways of ungodly people and the world. Amen. We're called to be set apart. We're called to be, as Christians, as believers, we are the salt of the earth. Amen. Amen. And so let us please stand as we extend invitation to Christian discipleship. Is there one today? Today's a great day to give your life to Christ. God has love for all of us. God's desire is not for us to perish. God's desire is for us to have everlasting life. God loved the world so much that he gave us his only begotten son, that whomever believes on him will not perish, but they would have everlasting life. Is there one today? God has touched your life. I guarantee, even before you came into the knowledge of God, God has touched your life. Is it one today? And if you're online, if you'd like for me to pray with you, to reach out to you, put that information in the chat. So it's a team, we'll make sure we receive it. Is it one? Today's a great day to give your life to Christ. Today's a great day to rededicate yourself, to have God rekindle the fire and desire to live according to his will and way in your life. Is it one? You can live again. God is with you. He's more than the world that's against you. One with God is the majority. Is it one? You may be seated. That's the song you need to sing. Thank you. Amen. Let's give God the praise. Amen. I pray that your service has richly blessed you. I pray that the prayers and the songs and the word of God on today has blessed you, and you've gotten the spiritual nourishment that you desire to have on today. Amen. Amen. Let us please remember the Roswell Grace to His program at 5 p.m. at Morning Chapel. Please remember tomorrow is our church conference at 7 p.m. by Zoom. And thank you, Robin, for joining with us on today. We pray for your safe travels back home. Amen. Let us praise God for the all blessed church.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly
Eternal God, our Father, we thank you, Lord, for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard, what our hearts have felt. We thank you, Lord, for the word on today that you delivered through your minister, Anthony Jones. Lord, we thank you, and we pray that your blessings will continue to flow in and throughout our lives. And we are blessed, Lord, we know, to be a blessing to others. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Hence now and forevermore. And the church said,
Amen.